Welcome to A Word from the Wise, the podcast from Solwise, where we talk about products, news, or anything that you might be interested in within the industry. We do these on Spotify, Amazon Music, or anywhere where you get your podcast from. Or if you prefer to see us, you can scare yourself and go and watch us over on YouTube and enjoy today's podcast. Hello everybody and welcome to another podcast from Solwise, The Word from the Wise. Today we're going to talk about the new Teltonika outdoor 4G router. So I've got Daniel with me from tech support, which is becoming the norm these days, isn't it, as Steve works more and more from home.
It is, yeah.
So we're becoming a bit of a proper double act. But today we're going to talk about the OTD140. That's this one here. It's an outdoor 4G router, and essentially I suppose my first question is what's the point? We sell the indoor routers and most often with an outdoor antenna, so what's the point of having something like this, do you think?
So the OTD140, the idea of it is that it's, along with being a router, it is also its own outdoor antenna to be put outside, and you know, being outdoor, okay, it's waterproof and everything. And obviously the whole reason that it's good to have an outdoor antenna in the first place is that mobile signals are a lot stronger outside than inside, so you want the antenna to be on the outside so it has an easy job of picking up stronger signals. This is an idea of just combining the outdoor antenna and indoor router into one bit of kit, without needing to buy an individual antenna and router and maybe cables to go in between.
So. And I suppose picking up on cables, that's going to be probably the most important thing when we talk about the having an outdoor antenna. You talk about having as short a cable as possible. We can't get much shorter.
Yeah, there's no loss of any signal gain over cabling on this. So obviously that's one key advantage, along with being a bit more convenient, a bit tidier.
And then once you've got this, it's going to have to cable in some way, shape or form. So I assume then from this comes out an Ethernet cable to something inside. What would you have inside?
Well, it needs to be powered via Ethernet cable, because obviously you're not going to get... It wants to be quite flexible in terms of where it can be mounted. It doesn't have like a 5 meter range limit that you typically get with an outdoor antenna that was separate.
Yeah.
And so in order to power it, they've had it so it's powered by PoE, which is power over Ethernet.
Yeah.
So you can get quite long cable lengths of that. It's 24 volt passive PoE, so you can get probably to about 40 odd meters before you start to get too long for the power to reach.
Right.
So you've got quite a bit of leeway with where you mount it there. But you'd have an Ethernet cable coming from it, going into a PoE injector of some kind, probably. We've got a few 24 volt ones that would be fine for that.
So it doesn't come with anything, it just comes on its own. It's the unit in the box along with the bit of paper with the manual on, and that's all it comes. So there's, depending on what you're doing, you have to buy the extra bit. So you're going to need whatever you're going to indoors, however long cable you need, and whatever PoE injector that you're going to need.
And obviously it doesn't do its own Wi-Fi broadcasting, which in some cases wouldn't be useful if it did anyway, because you don't need Wi-Fi to be 40 meters up high outside or wherever it's going to be mounted.
Yeah.
You want it inside, like what the more traditional way of having the router inside would do that job on its own.
Yeah.
So going into the PoE injector on the inside, you'd probably have some kind of access point or Ethernet router. So if keeping with the Teltonika theme, you could have the Teltonika Rutex 10, which is an Ethernet router, or it could be going into a access point, like one of the EWS fit APs we do would be fine for that kind of job.
Or you could just have it going into a switch.
Yeah. And that could then go into some other bit of your network. Yeah, that's also fine.
Yeah.
I should also mention, since we're talking a bit about the PoE, one thing it does have, it's got two Ethernet ports inside its case. I'll just
if you open it up and show those that are watching.
Let's see how easy
I knew we
it
should have done
open.
This before. It's they're quite stiff, but I mean there's good reason for that. Obviously,
you just have to press it down and you can get it open.
Obviously, you don't want to get anything in there.
So it's got two Ethernet ports. One is the PUE input, which obviously is for power.
Yeah.
But the other port, along with being a standard Ethernet port, it can also do PUE output,
so it can
power other PUE compatible devices nearby.
Well, as it happens, we've seen a video today, haven't we, from Teltonika, where he's got one of these on one side of his truck, and on the other side, he's actually got a camera. So I suspect that's maybe what he did there, then.
Yeah,
did he power the camera?
If you've got an IP camera that's powered by PUE passive, then this can do the job of that, and you don't have to have a separate power supply running up to the camera or any other things. So that's one other advantage of it.
And the SIM slots in there.
It's got two SIM slots in there. So just like many of the other Teltonika routers, the second SIM slot is primarily for failover rather than being, it doesn't use both at once. So if your primary mobile network stopped working for whatever reason, if you ran out of data or the network went down, or if you're travelling somewhere with it, if you've got it mounted on a vehicle, then you can hop over to the other one seamlessly without losing your network connection.
So I suppose if you were going abroad, you could have a UK one in it and your foreign one you get there. That might be quite
That's
useful.
What a lot of people do, when they're travelling throughout Europe and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's a Cat4 router, this one, so up to 150 meg speeds, which should be just about enough.
Adequate for what most people reality, a bit of social media networking and finding out where bits go.
It's got the same interface and settings as all the other Teltonika routers, so anyone that's used them will be familiar with it and know how to navigate it. And
for those that use the RMS, can this be used on RMS as well?
Yeah. So it also obviously supports RMS, so just like all the other Teltonika routers, really. It's very similar internally, it's just the whole format it's in that's a bit different.
What about mounting options then? So
it's got an integrated mount there.
Doesn't come with any of the bits, does it? So you choose how you want to mount it, and then you'll either need to get screws to go through or
You can
some cable ties or however you want to do it.
So it can be pole mounted or stuck on a wall or something like that.
And this does come out, doesn't it? There is a screw inside.
Yeah, it comes with the back plate already attached to it, so it can fit everything in the box easier, but then you can just pop that off if you're not using it.
Or you'll have to pop off to put the screws on. When I first looked at it, I thought, how are you going to get the screws in there? But then we did discover, didn't we, there was a screw inside to release it. Okay, so one or two people have mentioned, certainly when we watched the Teltonika launch about this, they queried the fact that it's IP55. Now, for the vast majority of people, in reality, IP55 is going to be fine, isn't it? Because the way IP ratings go is the first number is about water and dirt, which is the first five, and then the second number is about the moisture. So if you've got IP55 and you're comparing it to IP65, from a water point of view, it's just as good.
It's just as fine for the standard stuff it's going to be involved in. So it's dust and water ingress at pressure, it's fine with. So rain, anything like that. Mud, anything at all, it should be fine with.
Yeah.
Just the fact that it's not IP65 just means you don't want to drop it in the sea.
The first number is to do with more to do with dirt resistance. So I did write this down. So it's about partial protection against dust ingress and will not damage performance. If it were a 65, you'd give you full protection with a vacuum seal. So really the second number is about moisture and the first is more about slight water and dirt resistance.
It's fine for rain, that's the important thing.
There is a video on Teltonika's YouTube, which we will link to in the description, and it's also on the product page, which shows, have you seen the video where the chap drives through the forest?
Yeah, he's got it on his SUV or something, and it's driving down a muddy road and he gets covered in water and mud from the, obviously, rain.
And then he takes it to the car wash place, doesn't he, and then hoses it down. He doesn't go through one of the car wash things that, with the rollers. No, he does it with the spray wash thing, a jet wash. He does it with one of those, doesn't he? So I think from that point of view...
That video is on the product page.
It is on the product page now, yeah. But I do think people were worrying unnecessarily about the IP rating. I think actually, in reality, it's probably fine for what the vast majority of people are going to want, certainly in this country. And we get enough rain, don't we? So it's not like it's going to be too much of a problem.
And as we demonstrated, the bottom case seals on quite tightly.
It does, yeah. More so about getting it off.
Yeah.
So I think that's about it, really. You buy the device, you're going to need to buy some Ethernet cable, a PoE injector, and something to use inside.
I don't know if I mentioned, but it's got two internal LTE antennas, and they're omnidirectional. Right. So that's what you want, really. It's convenient in any scenario.
So get it mounted up as high as possible on a pole or something like that.
And
should do the job for people.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much. If you're listening to this, you can watch it on YouTube and you can see the bits about the mountings and so on. And if not, well, then we'll see you next time. Thank you. Thank you for either watching or listening to today's podcast. If you've got any ideas, pop us an email over to sales@solwise.co.uk. And we will see you next time.